Hey guys, I'm Cole here, and over the weekend I have been playing the closed beta to Hawken, which is an upcoming free-to-play game, which involves, it's a FPS game with mechs. So if you're a fan of Mech Warrior, Armored Core, you'll like it. It just doesn't seem to have as much customization as those this particular time. And over the weekend I have been playing it when I can get into a server, and recorded things on and off to check out how it works. So far, I was a little iffy about the game. I was playing it at first, and I thought it was a little too repetitive, a little dull, but then I kind of got the hang of it, and I found it to be a lot more enjoyable. So we'll start off with some basic stuff here. You've got your typical types of two currencies available. Like most free-to-play games, Tribes Ascend, League of Legends, there's a currency you can use that you build up from playing the game. Experience points, and something you can use to purchase. Now, I didn't pay any money, and there's no option to do it at this time. I just was given some so I could actually unlock some things. So go ahead and hit the garage here and see what we got. First class everybody starts off with is this thing that looks like a damn television with guns and a windshield wiper. It's called the Assault class. Most of the players are using it at this time. I like it. Whenever I play Armored Core or anything else like that, I always liked the smaller, quicker mechs. Something that I could kind of shoot at, stay away, run away, whatever I need to do. So I haven't actually checked out the bigger classes yet. I've only used these smaller ones. And I've actually taken a liking to the Sharpshooter class. Infiltrator, I actually haven't used yet. I've only seen them out on the field. They have a camouflage ability, which is pretty cool. It makes them basically disappear, but if you pay attention, you can still see them. It just gets difficult the further away they are. And sharpshooter, sniper, assault class, just your basic fighter. And they all have a special ability. The ability for this guy, weapon damage, increases damage for a short period of time. Assault has an ability that reduces their heat timer. Unlike most games, when you fire weapons in this game, you don't have ammunition. Your weapons have a heat meter. As you fire weapons, they overheat. So the more you fire them, the more the heat bar fills up. Once it fills up completely, your weapons overheat, and your weapon systems will shut down for a short period of time. Basically means you run like a little bitch because you can't do anything. Your radar, everything shuts down. I'll show you the heads-up display in the game in a minute here. Here's an example of what happens when you overheat your weapons. The two bars around your center crosshair are actually have a heat meter, which I'll show here in a second. Here they are. You get plenty of warnings before your weapon systems overheat. Display. The bottom right has a little monitor that shows your use items, shields, radars, guns, whatever, your deployables. The little orange one is your fuel meter, which drops as you jet. The one with the big numbers is your mech's health bar, and the one in the bottom left, zero, is how much energy you have when you're playing in siege mode. You collect it and return it. This top one's a little fist, that's your mech's special use. Top right has your radar, and below that will occasionally show up things that are being fought for, in this case, the anti-aircraft. So what you've got here is you've got the different game modes. You've got Siege, Deathmatch, Team Deathmatch, and Missile Assault. Deathmatch is the simplest. It's basically a free-for-all, everybody against everybody. Team Deathmatch, same thing, you're just on teams. So by the time the 10 minutes has gone by, the team that has the most kills wins. Missile Assault is a very interesting mode where there are three missile silos on the map, and they constantly bombard each other's bases. Now, however many you control, your team controls, is how many missiles will fly at the enemy base. So it's basically just node control. Siege is the same thing. There'll be a map with two nodes that you gather energy, and then you return it to your base. Once you've acquired enough energy, you launch a ship. Then you have to control an anti-aircraft in the middle of the map. when you control that, then what happens is a ship will fly over and ram into the enemy base. And if you do that three times, if you get that done three times, then your team wins. If you launch a ship and the opposing team is controlling the anti-aircraft node in the middle, then your ship will just take tons of damage from these missiles, and I believe it's three or four missiles will destroy it. Even if you only get a couple off and your team loses control of the anti-aircraft, you can shoot the thing down. I'll show that in a little bit. And now on to some of the gameplay.